like I said, the view is simply amazing. I could stand here and spend hours literally just looking at the view. And of course, having an ice cold beer on this deck with this view is my idea of bliss. As you can see, in this particular hunting lodge, the balcony extends all around the outside of the house, which is amazing. It really does help to link the inside of the hunting lodge with the amazing nature outside. And again, 360 views apart from the car park. This area, not so much, but everywhere else has pretty amazing views. I'm sure you'll agree. As we peek in the window, you can also see that this hunting lodge is a very nice place to be. Have this giant statue here of a fierce bear. I love the way that this statue is made. It's got a very special texture, and it looks very apt sitting on the railings of my hunting lodge. Okay, let's venture inside. See what else this hunting lodge has to offer. As you can see, you walk into some nice rocks, stylish but classic rocks, and we have some nice ornaments and very old school antique drawers. This is a very simple room. You can use it as an office. An office with simply amazing views. I'm sure you'll agree. It also has a wardrobe in it, so you can use this to keep your hunting gear in when you're not using it. So this is what I would usually loan out to a guest when I have a guest at my lodge hunting. This could be where we might set up for this hunt, or the hunt that we're going to go on together. As you'll see throughout the lodge, it's a very classic style with log walls and very classic antique furniture. Okay, let's continue, shall we? Kind of hybrid living environment where you can also as a social area, either before a hunt, maybe having a coffee, or after a hunt, enjoying a dinner together. As you can see, we've just enjoyed a coffee together, and we're about to go out on a hunt soon. I really like this kind of breakfast bar style area, which is raised up with matching antique stalls. It really does add a great social element to the hunting lodge, in my opinion. Again, amazing views out of every window. It really is priceless. Over here, this is where I keep my extra mugs and cups ready to go. And of course, as you can see, we have ample storage. In my hunting lodge, I like to keep a lot of items, food items, that are pickled because of the fact that it's hard to always have an abundance of fresh food in my hunting lodge. So, by having a wide range of food that is pickled, it helps me to add more volume to the fresh food that I bring up each time I go on a hunt. And of course, I need chopping boards and saucepans and other pans to help with this cooking. Although, I think someone has snuck into my hunting lodge and provided me with a massive jar of baked beans. Not only one, but two massive jars of baked beans. I have to say, I would never personally buy a massive jar of baked beans, so someone must have gifted me this item without my knowledge. Over here, of course, we have a fridge. Nothing too fancy, because we do have a limited supply of electric up here in the hunting area that we're in. But one important element of any hunting trip is the coffee. So we have this Italian style stove pot that you can use to make your own coffee. And then we have various utensils, from spatulas to spoons with holes in, to mashed potato mashers, to ladles. These are very important when we're cooking in the hunting lodge, as I'm sure you can imagine. Again, you see that we're very busy in the lodge. We've just been cooking recently, as you can see. Again, even though this is not the best view in the lodge, imagine having to do the washing up here and look at this view and see the nature roaming outside. It is truly amazing, even if I do say so myself. And then, of course, we have our seating area, a place for relaxing by the roaring fire, with a megaphone that sometimes plays relaxing tunes. I really enjoy hanging out here, relaxing after a busy day of hunting, and there's nothing more satisfying than relaxing by a roaring fire. designer, but to me, I would call it an Aztec theme. And of course, a hunting lodge has to have a substantial fireplace, as this one surely does, with its chunky logs and stones. It really is the perfect fit. When you are tired of your relaxing or eating or preparing for your next hunt, of course you can retire up these beautiful log stairs to more areas used to display your hunting trophies. Unfortunately, I have a particularly busy life. I've not had a chance to do a lot of hunting in this particular hunting lodge, but mark my words, at some point this room will be filled with amazing hunting trophies. I have to say, I love the natural light that is coming into the upstairs area, mainly from these huge windows, which I would call church style windows, even though they're not stained windows like in a church. The size and shape of them really do remind me of a church, but the amount of natural light that comes in and the views that you can see from them is simply amazing. Now, of course, we have another smaller area with armchairs and yet another Aztec rug with a small coffee table that you can use to relax when you're up here in the hunting lodge with a hunting party. It's nice that the hunting party can break out into several groups and relax, some here, some downstairs, and myself even in my own bedroom. This really is a wonderful thing when you're on a hunt with a hunting party. Now, there's not much more to say apart from the striking outside area, although I do want to draw your attention to these amazing light fixtures that I had custom made for my hunting lodge, that are made out of the antlers of deers. I feel they really add to the theming of this particular hunting lodge. Now, let's venture outside. Balcony area here is very similar to the balcony area downstairs, although it's not as long or big. However, as you are higher up, you can get slightly nicer views out here. As you can see, we have another balcony area access on the opposite side too, with the most spectacular view you're ever going to see. I could literally stand out here for hours and admire this amazing view, watch herds of wildebeest or other animals sweeping past my vantage point, or watch and hear the pitter-patter So as we peer out on this beautiful